What's going on, YouTube fan? It's your boy Tony Two Times, and we back with another episode of The Baltimore Way, man. I appreciate the love and support, like I always tell y'all. Be sure to like, comment, share, check out that join button, man. Y'all already know I'm rocking with y'all like y'all rocking with me, man. Y'all thought I forgot about y'all tonight, then y'all. But let's get right into it. So tonight we're gonna talk about that boy Tae Cobain, real name Joshua Goods. He was born April 28th, 1992, in Baltimore, Maryland. He from Northeast Baltimore, to be exact. During his teenage years, he relocated to York, Pennsylvania, and attended Central York High School before dropping out to pursue his rap career full-time in 2013. Both Tate's mother and father passed away months apart from each other, leaving him responsible for his eight younger siblings at just 21 years old. That made him go even harder at music and perfect his craft. Also, he had five kids of his own. He was spending time between Baltimore and York, Pennsylvania. That gave Cobain a different flow, and the aggressive Baltimore flow, and also that kind of, y'all know that Pennsylvania flow, them Philly boys and them York PA boys, they real aggressive. As a child, Tate liked to dance and was nicknamed Dancing Tater. That's how he got his rap name. Tate always been talented. He wanted to be a video game programmer, but his love for music took over. At age five, he started singing in the church choir and began writing music at age 11. He also read music and played instruments. He was in music production classes in high school. Tate's uncle is Baltimore rapper Killer Q. That was one of his earlier influences. Also Cassidy, Method Man, and Mr. Cheeks. Cobain started taking off shortly after he released a Baltimore remix of classic song, Bankrolls, originally made by Tim Trees in the year 2000. That got the attention of Lior Cohen and Baltimore native Kevin Lyles of 300 Entertainment. At first, Tate was hesitant about signing the deal. He researched the label and looked up the artists to see how they could help each other in the new venture. In July 2015, Cobain traveled to New York to sign a deal with 300 Entertainment. Soon after, he appeared on the label's 13 City Young Hustle Tour, which featured Rich the Kid, T-Wayne, and more artists. In 2016, Tate released We Are Here to Mixtape, which he freestyled and remixed songs. On his single Poppin', he shot that at a Georgia Waffle House, a real spontaneous video. Cobain has worked with fellow Baltimore artist Young Moose and Baltimore producer Gennaro Beats. In Bankroll's remix, he actually had a verse remembering K Swift, the Baltimore club queen. I got a Baltimore way on her, y'all. Make sure to go check that out. Rest in peace, K Swift. And also, after Freddie Gray passed away, he dropped the song to bring the city together and bring a sense of happiness and pride to Baltimore. He do shoe giveaways, charity. He got some songs dropped recently called Christmas in the North, I Remember, featuring K Camp. Also his older songs, Big 28, and his 2017 CD, Tate Co. He got another one called Silent Waves, Oh My. So bro been working. And I feel like this is dope because I don't feel like bro get the recognition he should get. I like his music, I like his style, because it's different, you know what I mean? Like at first, I didn't even know he was from Baltimore until I did my research and looked more into his story and realized he was back and forth between Baltimore and Pennsylvania. So a lot of people don't know that. Now he said something interesting in the interview. He told artists, like, don't be so quick to just sign a deal. You know, he shopped around, he talked to labels, he wanted to stay independent, but the deal made sense, so he signed the deal. But he said you gotta know your worth. And that's real, because a lot of artists out here, they don't know their worth. And if you take a dude from the hood that ain't got nothing, that's in the projects, and you put $10,000, $20,000 in front of his face, more than likely he gonna sign that deal. But a lot of these dudes be getting got, and that's how you get the 360 deal. But if you know that you gonna do something when you get in the industry, and I wouldn't say don't take the deal, because everybody's situation different. Some people gotta get out the hood. Like, they in situations with people trying to take them out, or they lights out, or they rent ain't getting paid. They gotta help their parents. They gotta help their siblings, kind of like how bro was. But he's smart because he took his time and signed a deal that made sense for him. Now he been working on his recent music, you know what I mean? He dropping bangers. But he also got that song with K Camp that's doing numbers. That's popping down here. Now, I feel like bro, he a big inspiration to the city because he ain't in no trouble. You know what I mean? He doing positive things like giveaways, stuff like that. And he said one thing that stood out, he wanna pass the torch to the next person from the city. That's what I always say. He wanna reach down and bring somebody else up. He ain't trying to keep the fame just for himself. He's saying that when everything get good and his label get right, he gonna go back to the city and get the next talented artist and bring them up, and then they could pass the torch and so on and so on. And that's how you do it. Now, Leo and them was basically telling him when he went to sign his deal, like the light is on Baltimore right now. And you could be like one of the head runners. You could be one of the first people to sign. So that's what made him want to take the deal. Now, that's crazy they said that, because I do feel like in these past years, the light had been shining on Baltimore. I remember growing up and being younger, we ain't have that many people. Everybody we had was local, other than Drew Hill and like comedians and like the Braxton sisters and stuff like that. But now we got rappers, we got entertainers. So the light on us, you feel me? So anybody from the city, if you rap, whatever you do, even if you do YouTube, if you a filmmaker, if you make clothes, try to push it, because people watching, people curious about Baltimore, because a lot of people don't know about our culture, our slang, the way we talk, the way we dress. That's why I do these videos, I always tell y'all. But yeah, man, Take O Bang, it's a dope story, because for him to lose both his parents so young and still be out here to maintain and not go a messed up route and go to prison or end up laying out in these streets, that show a lot about his character, because you got to be strong, you got to be focused to make it in this game. So y'all go show him some love, man. Y'all go check out his YouTube channel. He got some dope music on there. He got a lot of uploads, you know what I mean? Y'all go subscribe, listen to it, and go check out them CDs. I know that Take Cold, that's hard. I was listening to that earlier, because I always try to, before I do these videos, get in the mindset of the people, listen to the music, you know what I mean? Watch interviews and stuff like that, so I can know a lot about their story and their upbringing. But yeah, man, y'all already know this is another episode of The Baltimore Way. I appreciate the love and support y'all been giving me, man. It means everything. It means the world. We on that race to 20K. With y'all help, we gonna get there. When we get there, I'm gonna do a giveaway. I love y'all, gang. I'm out.